Hey folks, Lanchard here, welcome back to episode 6 in my Diary of a Techno Wizard series. I'm here on the Primus server playing the Unabridged mod pack. And today, I want to get into a little bit more blood magic. Basically, I'm just going to poke around at some different things. I actually have a bunch of different things I need to do and show you. And first thing I want to show you, I put this elevator here from OpenBlocks. These are actually pretty cheap, OpenBlocks elevators. Real easy to make. Just some wool and an ender pearl gets you an elevator, and then you can go up and down. So right below my witch altar, I've gone ahead and set up a circle for doing some witchery stuff. I've already used that to charge up one stone. So I can now make charged attune stones. There's some things I might be needing those for later. Plus it allows me to basically bottle my altar power and use it where I don't necessarily have an altar. So that's going to be good. So there's some things that I might want to do like out away from where I have an altar. And now I have the ability to do those, do some circle magic away from my altar. Moving right along. What else over here? Not too much else over here. Yeah, there was something I was getting ready to set up. As you see, I've moved out all of my chests that I had down here, and we'll get to where all that went here in a little bit. But before, actually, we're gonna have to get to there, to that like right now. I made a modular storage from RF Tools. I made a few technical devices, but the thing that first of all, I made that environment controller that I talked about making last time. So I had enough emerald, diamond, and all the rest of the stuff to go ahead and make that. And then I went ahead and made a regeneration plus module for that, which required me to make a iron golem. Now, he has since got himself killed, but I originally had an iron golem over here in town. He actually wandered too close to the whatever the flower it is that does the damage. I can't remember. It's not the Vinculatus. Is it? It should be down here somewhere. I don't know if I can even see it. No, I don't see it. Can I see it? Oh, it's under that. I think it's under that piece of dirt right there. No. Cannot see it. It's a good place to grow mushrooms down here, apparently. Okay. Well. Oh. I suppose this sign right here tells me. The Hyacidus. That's the one that's dealing the damage, I'm pretty sure. Why is this guy here? That's definitely not on. He must just be a random teleport guy. Oh, get some lag there. Get rid of that guy. What was I saying? Yeah, modular storage. Uh-oh. Doesn't want to open. I wonder why that is. Now, I've been able to... whoops. I think we're just... okay, I see. We're just having some server lag here. There we go. And all my stuff is in here now. And I'll show you where that's located here. Let me just head over to the spire. Oh, I was telling you I made an iron golem so that I could make this right here, because you need syringes from an iron golem. It actually takes three of them, because you got to make the tier one, which requires a syringe from an iron golem, and then the tier two is just two more syringes. And we'll go see what I've done with that over here. There's two major things I want to get into today. I want to set up some kind of automation for my blood altar to help me out getting all those runes that I need to make it like higher tier. I haven't had a chance to do that. Actually, almost no time has passed since I recorded the last episode. So come over here to Spire. I did get a loader. I have to have a chunk loader, because if I don't have this remote storage loaded, I can't access it from other places in the world. And I actually need to set this. Where is it? I need at least one of these set to cross-dimensional, but I'm kind of afraid. Now, right now, I'm just using some Ender IO, Sterling Generator, for power. That kind of goes against what I was saying before about using magic for power, but I can power this ender generator with some blood magic once I get to that level of capability. So I think I might do that. It was suggested that I use the Batania one, but I thought that if I did that, I would probably be causing too much lag on the server because of the amount of automation and flower stuff that would have to be going on for me to make enough power to power what I wanted to do. And I really only need the alloy smelter, the sag mill, for some various things that I do occasionally. And this thing right here, the environmental controller, this thing is key. I showed you the recipe for that. It is quite expensive to make, but it is worth it. Now I have the radius turned down to the minimum and the height turned down to the minimum so that it doesn't require as much power to make it work. So minimum amount of power to make that work. Or I think. I've also got it set so that I can toggle it with this lever. So, and I'm using the generator from right here to do that. So what happens is when I turn this on, I get a nice little effect above it, but even more importantly, I get regeneration 3, which is perfect. So now I can stand here and load up my blood altar. If I get my, I think it might be in there. Yes, it is. I have moved everything into the, in fact, I should just pull this stuff out, because this is the stuff I wanted to use for automating the blood altar. I made these canvas bags. These are really easy. I made these canvas bags before I made this storage module, and I had been using those a little bit. I'm going to keep this black one because that one's kind of special. That's my bag of souls. I got to collect a few more people, but I don't plan on doing anything with that. That's just kind of like a trophy for me. So those folks don't really got to worry about it, but I thought that would be kind of a cool thing to have. So I got my weak blood orb, and I got this. Oh yeah, I was wanting to demonstrate what happens when I go to fill this back up. See, I can pump a bunch of blood into it, and I regenerate insanely fast. So I'll be able to keep blood in it for what I want to do. So there we go. The other nice thing about having all of my, pretty much almost all of my stuff, almost. There's a few things still over there, and there'll be a few things in like some caches, like the large modular storage, like netherrack, cobble, things like that, that I don't really want to keep in the modular storage. But this thing, I've got 4 tabs of 300 stacks each in it. So I think I'd probably be able to keep almost everything in there until I get my applied energistic system working. And I think it might even be possible to have my applied energistic system interact with this as an inventory. So we'll see. We shall see what I do about that. But you know what? Might notice that I made some item translocators. Kind of expensive, but I think they're going to be worth it. I don't remember if I need a diamond or not for these to make them work to do what I want them to do. I don't have a chest. Actually, let's, there we go. Shift click it in and it'll stack. If you just drop it in there and you don't land on the other stack that you already have, it might not go in. So what I want to do is I want to pull out of this chest some stone. And I don't know if I got enough stone. I don't know if I got any stone. Let me see. Should we check in here? I can turn some brick into some stone. That should be enough to get it set up. Somewhere I should have a chisel. There we go. I also made myself a Yetter wrench so that I would be able to deal with the Ender IO stuff. And the I don't know if I'm going to need a wrench for any of the RF tool stuff that I have planned on that I plan on using. I think this might be the only RF tool stuff I use. I might use the dimensional stuff as well a little bit. I think that's the only method of creating dimensions. There's no miscraft or anything in the pack. The other thing I was thinking about potentially using, maybe, was the... There's a... I don't know if I can find it or not in here. There's a generator thing that you can use. Is this it? Yeah, and endergenic generator uses ender pearls to generate power in a kind of a convoluted way, but it's really cool. Yes, there's a pearl injector, there's an energetic generator. And then there's some other things. No, matter, but those are both related to teleportation. These are the two that are related. And this one. No? Yeah. This one. The Ender Monitor. These three devices can be used to kind of make a generator that I'm not sure if it would be considered magical or not, using Ender Pearls to generate power. I think I would probably put it in that classification, though. So what I want to... Whoops. I want this on this side. Not this side. Oh, come out of there. What I want to do is these things... Yeah, there we go. If I tell it to do that, and I put some stone in there, and I push this. Okay, so it just puts all the stone in there. Okay, I don't want to do that. Let's put the stone back over here. What I want it to do is only keep one stone in there. Now, if I look in here, I've only got one stone in there. So if I take a diamond, let's see here, diamond somewhere. Whoops, about on this tab. There we go, diamond. And then I crack that into diamond nuggets and apply it to, do I have a shift click? How do I do this? I know there's a way to put it on there. Am I doing something wrong? I got the wrong stuff. Enhanced portals. Uh-oh. We might have a conflict. So I need... Translocator. Translocator. Diamond nugget. How do I get this? Oh, great. So we got a conflict in recipes here. Okay, I think I'm going to have to figure this out and get right back to you. All right, Nonsanity helped me out. He just gave me some nuggets and told me to trash the diamond, so I've already trashed the diamond, and I got the proper nuggets, and he's going to go ahead and report that to the pack author, and that should be fixed next release, I would imagine, so... Now I just put that on there. Oh, yeah. Now this should keep, if I click it with my hand, there we go, keeps one stone in there. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Okay, so next all I need is to get them back out. So we can go ahead and put another set of translocators on this side. And we're going to pull that out of there. And I want to tell this to pull out those. And I don't need a diamond on this one, so... I can just let this one go. So it'll pull out any blank slates that end up in there and put them back in the chest. So there we go. I've automated this with some translocator. I think that's nice and magical looking. I was originally going to use some ender conduit, but I decided to go with this solution instead because this has a fairly easy ability to control the amount of items that are inserted at a time, as long as you can get the diamond nuggets. So... issue solved. Alright. So now all I need to do is hang out here and get a whole lot of slates, turn those into runes, and I can power up my altar here. Now I also need to take a look at how much, see if I have any marble in here. I don't know if I have any marble or not. Yeah, I haven't really collected any marble yet, so I still need to go out and get that. Maybe I will contract with somebody to get some marble. Some folks have been asking for stuff that I would make stuff for them from out of magic, like wands. Wands of this wand, my favorite wand, with the equal trade folks on it, is one that a lot of people would like to use. There's also a tech version in this pack, but... I don't know, some people just prefer the magic. They do work differently, so you may not like the way the one the tech one works, because it only works on one plane at a time. Whereas the wand will basically spread around in any direction to any connected or diagonally connected blocks of the same type that are exposed to air. So now I can definitely get this thing, get my slates made really fast. So we're not doing bad there. And I think this is right here is like going to be pretty much the majority of my tech. I mean, this is pretty much it. And like I said, eventually I'm going to power this using blood power, but I'm not at the level of blood magic that I need to be yet to do that. So, but this is going to help me a lot. This is really simple automation here. In fact, you know, I really didn't, now I'm thinking about it, I really didn't need these extra two. Because I really can just use this one and tell this one to pull out slates. I didn't even think about that. Good thing I thought about that before I put this video up, because you guys would probably tell me all about it. No? Maybe it doesn't work that way. Slates. Okay, maybe they only go one direction. Yeah, I guess I can't. I guess I do need the second one then. Okay, well, I thought I didn't. So we'll do this again and set this back to that. There we go. Now it's back to doing its thing. Oh, what happened here? Is it not why it decided to stop working? Something in there? I don't know. Well, here, we'll just reset this. Get some stone. Set that to one stone. Put back in there. That one on there. There it goes. Okay. So whatever I did, I broke it temporarily. But now it should be fixed again, so. And do I have enough to go tier 2 yet? Not quite, I don't think. Or do I? I have to go get more stone anyway. But the other main, really big thing that I want to do this episode, because I need to do a whole lot of infusion. I really want to get deeper into Farmcraft, but the problem is I need a fusion altar. I need an infusion altar before I can do that. Come on, let me fly. There we go. I think this chunk loader is actually going to go someplace else. Let's move that a little bit, because what's actually going to happen is the infusion altar is going to be centered right on that point. So let's come down. Actually, let's just put this in the basement in the center for now. There we go. Should have the same effect down here. I like having a little bit bigger hole to kind of fly through. There we go. That's a little easier. For now. I'm going to do that so I don't forget where the center is at. And what I need to do is I need to... I don't know if I have enough yet or not. Pull those stones out of there. And let's see, it's that actually, that's exactly enough. Problem is I don't have enough stone. So I gotta go get some stone and some materials. I think actually I got most of the materials I need that are actually in my storage system now. Like, I moved almost all my magic stuff into here. Oh, not that tab, but it's in here. Actually, that should not be in there. That should be over on the tab with the rest of the magic stuff. Over here. There we go. And in here I should have like all kinds of water shards and stuff like that. Actually, yeah, let me go back over to the hovel and put together the infusion altar core and stuff over there, because that's where the cauldron is at. I think I'm going to need it. All right, I'm back over at the hut, and I want to show you something else that I did between this episode and last. I added the second tally box, and I kind of rearranged it slightly, but now I got two tally boxes, one for each side. Both have the whitelist of Living Rock in it, and it just uses the red crystal to come down and feed that in there. They're both stuffed right now. Actually, this one's not stuffed. Why is it? Oh, it's almost full, but not quite. So it got hung up at some point, so I just need to re-toggle it. There it goes. So now that each one of these have their own tally box, I won't get that issue where this one gets jammed up because it has cobblestone in it. I also probably should get some more living wood because I'm going to need that here soon. Oop. Don't want to use my greatwood for that. I could, but I'd much rather use something that I don't need for other things. So I'm just going to put some wood down in the middle of here to give me a little bit of living wood from time to time. Store that in there. Okay, the main thing I came over here for, though, is to get this, to get my matrix, my fusion matrix put together. So I'm going to need a bunch of arcane stone. That's just shards and stuff. In fact, let's get some shards. Let's see what kind of shards we got, how much we got of each one before I decide what I'm going to use. So we'll go. I love the search function on this. There we go, shard. It seems that I have water shards in plentiful supply. And we can just do this. So I'm going to go ahead and make myself... Forgot. This has to be done upstairs in the proper crafting table. In the arcane work table. There we go. I'm just going to go ahead and get a stack of those. Actually, get those last 9. Oh, I used up all the viz out of that. I've almost got this thing completely used up. Still has a lot of aqua and perdido in it. I'm not sure what I would need that for, but probably something. Okay, and then the rest of this is it's going to be an ender pearl. Starting to run a little low on ender pearls. I'm down to less than a stack, but I can refresh those anytime I want because I'm so close to the spawner. There we go, and I need to get myself a runic matrix. All right. That's the main thing. So the other thing I'm going to need is, let's get those while we're right here. Some arcane pedestals. I need at least, I usually do 9 of these. I don't think there's anything in this pack that requires more than 8 pedestals. Actually, there might be. Let me check something real quick. There might be something actually that I might want to do soon that might require more than 8 pedestals. This right here. So yeah, that's definitely more than 8 pedestals. That's what, 4, 8, 9, 10, yeah. So yeah, we're gonna need more pedestals. At least, actually, yeah, we're gonna need, since I want to keep it a particular, there we go, that should do, I hope. Then I'm also gonna need some of these right here. Just need 4 of those for the regular ones. I still have 4 some regular ones, so that should be everything I need for my infusion altar. Should be. I don't know if you guys noticed this, but I put this XP drain down on a barrel. I made myself a drum just because I thought it would be a good idea to not lose the massive amount of levels that I had built up. I had about 75 at one point, and that was the point that I decided I would make this. And now I have a full drum of experience for when I go to do some kind of enchanting or do anything like that. I still got some levels left over. Okay, so I guess while I'm over here, before I head back over to the other place, I'll take care of this right here. So one of the reasons I wanted to clear out this wall is because I want to make something. And you'll see, let me put my wrench in my hand so you can see that I have a conduit facade right there. Right behind that is a bit of liquid conduit that is pulling out of an infinite water source from pressure pipes. An infinite water source is relatively easy. Water source right there is just 2 buckets and some iron, and then you can pump water out of it infinitely. And what that is going to pump itself into is going to be a witchery thing. I need the cauldron. It's not the cauldron. Brew thingy. Where is it at? Did I pass it up? No. I know it's a thing. Is it this? Silver vat. I don't remember that. Blood crucible. That's new. There's definitely some new things going on here in witchery that I don't recognize. That's what I'm looking for. Kettle. The icon for it is different than what you would think, but I need to get it a tombstone, some sticks, and a cauldron, some string. I got a couple of tombstones made down here, so I'm just going to grab one from in here. Give me one of those. Some sticks, some string, and a cauldron. So we'll need iron, string, and sticks. And then we'll just have to make ourselves a cauldron. Let's see if we can shift click this. Yeah, we can. Good. Kettle. Perfect. That didn't take very long at all. And now that I put that there, that should fill with water. Maybe. I don't know if it's connected or not. Am I not connected? Oh, it's connecting. Oh, I'm... Oh, the other thing I need to do is I need to light that down underneath. Let's do that. Where'd I put my flint and steel? I just had it, I swear. Flint and steel, did I not pull it out? Oh, it's on my bar, right there. Blind. Whoa! Let's light it first. Light that down in there, and then we'll put that there. Yeah, I was gonna say, am I gonna go out? I hope so. Now, hopefully, this should automatically get filled with water. I know I was able to auto. Oh, it is. It is full. It's just a trick of my texture pack that's causing me not to be able to see the water in it. But Wayla is telling me that it is full of water, which is perfect. So now I'll be able to use that to do the different brews from witchery, like, particularly things like love potion and some of these, any of these things that say brew. We're going to get into some other stuff before I do that, but I just want to get that there, set it up, and now I'm good to go. I have a place where I can do some brewing with a kettle instead of a cauldron. Slightly different. Actually, majorly different. So anyway, back over to the spire to set this up. Actually, I'm going to close up the secret passages. Close those up. And then fly over there. Alright. First of all, I'm going to remove that and put a pedestal there. That's the center. Then we're going to need to put that there just so we can get our runic matrix in the proper location. There has to be a space in between. Then we put the arcane bricks. Go around this and put an arcane stone on top of each of those. And then at this point, I think I can actually. I totally forgot my great wood wand. All I got is a stupid iron capped wand. In fact, this thing, goodbye. And I'm going to go get my great wood wand. I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back with my wand, and I had to do a quick recharge of it. I had to go find a node and tap it a little bit, but it's mostly full. I'm pretty sure I have enough to convert this, so I know it's expensive. It takes some viz, but there we go. What did it take? It takes 25 viz if you don't have any of the special clothing on that gives you bonuses or discounts. So there we go. I've got my infusion altar. Now I'm going to need to put some of these around. Now I usually go with just the 8. In fact, I could still go with just the, like, I make a really tight pattern of 8 around it like so. And then what I can do for the additional ones is I can actually just go ahead and put them out one. I need to put those back down because those are preventing mobs from spawning, so we'll go there and there. Let me guess. This one's right on a torch as well. There we go. Hopefully that doesn't... let me check. My F7? Oh, it does. Cause some extra dots. Some X's. Okay. But there we go. We got my infusion altar ready to go. Actually, that's not too bad. Maybe I should go... Maybe these should actually be here. It could work. But I think I like it better over here with a gap. Alright, we got an infusion altar, so now I will be able to do things like make a living wood wand core. Requires infusion. I kind of want to skip right to this. I think I want to go to the living wood wand core rather than the silver wood. I do have some silver wood. I went and found... it's in here. I went and found a magical forest and got myself some silverwood. You can see I got a couple stacks of silverwood. I got a few silverwood saplings. I also picked up some shimmerleaf while I was there. And that is like way... It's actually right by the ender portal that goes to the... Can I not zoom out to it? I don't even know where it's at. It's not over that way. Is it up this way? I don't think it saved my map. It's down here, actually, somewhere. But yeah, like right outside of the end portal fortress is a magical biome, and I was able to use the teleporter and non-sanities to go get close to it, and then go up onto the surface and pick up some silverwood trees and saplings. So I'll be able to grow some silverwood trees right over here and make the actual immediate area around here and magic biome, which I think would be appropriate. So the only other thing to do before I wrap this up is light this up and get rid of those X's. I didn't know there was X's in there. Good thing I had my F7 on when I came down to go ahead and make my tier 2 altar. So there's my other 7. Get rid of all of this. Technically, that does not need to be there. Now, eventually, we'll probably want to access the bottom of that altar later on, but that should now make it tier 2. Oh, and to check that, I guess we don't have the Walla thing upgrade, so I'm going to need to make a... I'm going to need to put some of this in there. I need to put some of this in there as well. Some blood. And I need to get some glass. Glass should be... I've kind of roughly got these tabs sorted. The majority of the crafting stuff is in this tab. Then I got a tab for food and plants and bees. I'm going to do some bees, so I've... Every time I see, like, I found a steadfast bee in a, I forget where I found that. I think it was under a chest under a spider tree. And a forest princess I got out of a village. So now I should have, yeah, there we go, some blank slates. I think it's just that blank slate and glass, if I remember this correctly. Yeah, I do. Divination sigil. So I'll be able to use that to check this. Yep, there we go. We are at tier 2. I'm pretty sure. I was quite sure that we would be at tier 2. They haven't changed that part of the mod in a long time. They have added to the altar. You can go up to tier 6 now instead of just tier 5. But I've not been able to get to a tier 6 altar in any playthroughs yet. So hopefully we'll get there in this one. That'll be fun. I'm sure that boss fight... that is involved. I'm pretty sure there's a boss fight involved with it, and I'm pretty sure that people will want to join in with me on that one. So, then when I'm not using it, I should remember to turn this off. Although, I've got plenty of energy coming from that. when I made these, I went ahead and made octatic capacitors for each one of them as well, because they're really not that hard in this mod pack. This doesn't have the hard mode on, so these are just some glowstone, some vibrant alloy, and energetic alloy, and basic capacitors, and yeah, not too difficult, as you can see. So next up, actually, I think that's where we're gonna wrap this up. I got a bunch done. I've got my tier 2 altar, and I'm serious this time. I'm gonna, between this episode and next, this is gonna go up to like tier 4, at least tier 4. Yeah, at least tier 4, because I don't think I can do tier 5 until I make a binding ritual. I'll probably want to do that one on camera. Even though I've done it before, it's something I always like to show because it's kind of cool. And there's some other things that I can bind. In fact, if we look at bound stuff, I can do the sword. That's an obvious one. You have to do that one because you need that to get the blood shards. But I can make a bound pick. And I think that those things might be fairly impressive, especially after I have a good amount of blood or life essence. Life pull. Once I have a really big life pull and I have a bunch of mobs powering my life pull, that one will be a good one to have. I don't really need the axe or the shovel, I don't think. I definitely want to make a set of bound armor. That's a whole different process. That's not a ritual, like a normal ritual. And then where's the other one? I could have swore that's a different mod. Well, we do have a bound chisel. I could have swore that there was a bound fishing rod, but I think that's mariculture, and I don't think that's in this pack. So, oh well. I do like the bound fishing rod. It's fun. But now that I have this altar and that altar, I'm going to be able to progress quite a bit and make some of the things that are being requested, people will want to trade for to get other resources that I don't necessarily have in abundance at the moment. But I'm pretty happy with that level of progress. I'm also going to be doing some more witchery stuff because you can see that I got access to the circles now, the kettle. I can start looking into maybe even possibly going to the dream dimension before too long, because that could be fun. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this as much as I enjoyed making it. If you did, be sure and leave a like, comment, and a thumbs up. And until next time, I will catch you later.